Hi folks, my name is Srinivasa Kollori and welcome to the beginner series for Azure MySQL. Let us begin by exploring some of the cost saving features within our flexible server offering. These fall into broad categories of burstable SKUs, leveraging free trial offering, features such as start stop and utilizing reserved instances. We commissioned the enterprise strategy group to validate the cost savings and improved business agility that customers reported when migrating on-premise MySQL instances to Azure Database for MySQL. As part of the analysis, ESG created a 3-year TCO and ROI model that compares the costs and benefits of migrating on-premise MySQL instances to Azure Database for MySQL. Some of the top-level findings from ESG's model found that Azure Database for MySQL provided up to a 48% lower total cost of ownership over a 3-year period. This included an enormous 93% reduction in the operational cost to deploy, manage, and maintain MySQL instances in an on-premise environment. In general, ESG found that on-premise deployments required significantly more time, effort, they were more complex and costly to manage. As organizations look to modernize and support their digital transformation efforts, Azure Database for MySQL and flexible server in general can reduce operational costs and improve business agility. With flexible server, you can provision low-cost B1 SKUs, which can be useful for new development. You can independently change the compute tier, compute size, vCores and memory, and the backup retention period. With burstable SKUs, you get initial credits. For example, the B1 MS gives 30 credits, and you also earn 12 credits per hour, all the way up to 288 credits. As long as you are within a baseline, say 20% of the CPU, you won't exhaust the credits, and in fact, you will accumulate credits. You can then do short-term high CPU work within the day. Once you exhaust the credits, the CPU limit drops down to the baseline and credits get reset every day. These SKUs are suitable for dev workloads where you don't use CPU while coding. And these are also great for small workloads such as WordPress applications. Let us now look at the Azure free trial. We will start by navigating to the website shown on the screen. This is the website for the Azure free trial, and developers can take advantage of building in Azure with a free account. Let us now navigate to the services section of the website. We're going to click on the free services section of the website, and then we'll navigate in the table all the way down to the Azure Database for MySQL. As you can see, the Azure free trial includes the option to try out the Azure Database for MySQL, and there is 750 hours of flexible server usage bundled in the free trial. This includes the usage of burstable instances, 32 GB of storage, and 32 GB of backup storage. The trial itself runs for 12 months, and one can move to a pay-as-you-go model beyond the free trial. This is a great way to sample the Azure ecosystem and also sample the Azure Database for MySQL. Let us now look at additional cost saving features that we have within our flexible server offering. Flexible server now gives you the ability to stop the server for up to 30 days when not in use, and to start the server within this time when you are ready to resume your development. This enables you to develop at your own pace and save development costs on the database servers by paying for the resources only when they are in use. This is important for dev test workloads and when you're only using the server for part of the day. When you stop the server, all active connections will be dropped. When the server is in the stopped state, the server's compute is not built. However, storage continues to be built as the server storage remains to ensure the data files are available when the server is started again. Flexible server now helps you save money by prepaying for compute resources compared to pay-as-you-go prices. With flexible server reserved instances, you make an upfront commitment on MySQL server for a 1 or 3 year period to get a significant discount on the compute cost. To purchase Azure Database for MySQL reserved capacity, you need to specify the Azure region, deployment type, performance tier, and term. Let us now navigate to our public pricing page for flexible server, which also displays pricings for the RIs. As you notice on the screen, this is our public pricing page. we will navigate to the flexible server portion of the page, and we will further navigate to the general purpose portion of the page. As you can see listed on the page, we have various compute tier instances listed within general purpose compute, and you have two pricing options specifically for the reserved instances. The very first thing I'm going to do is change the region from East US to Central US. Also, pricing for other regions is available when you change the region in the dropdown. I will leave the currency unchanged in US dollars, but pricing is also displayed for multiple other geographies. I'll also leave the display pricing unchanged by hours. As you can see, the 1 year reserved instances offer savings of up to 37% when compared to the pay as you go option. The 3 year reserved instances offer savings of up to 57% in the general purpose compute category. We can also look at the savings possible in the memory optimized instances. And as you can see, the 1 year reserved instances offer a saving of up to 43%, and the 3 year reserved instances offer a significant saving of 62% as compared to the pay-as-you-go options. In order to find the discount for your case, please visit the reservation blade on the Azure portal and check the savings per pricing tier and per region. Reserved instances help you manage your workloads, budget, and forecast better with an upfront payment for a 1 year term or 3 year term. You can also exchange or cancel reservations as businesses need change. Backup storage is the storage associated with automated backups of your server. Increasing your backup retention period increases the backup storage that is consumed by your server. There's no additional charge for backup storage for up to 100% of your total provisioned server storage. The backup retention period in flexible server can be from 1 to 35 days. Reduce the backup retention period to optimize costs if a longer retention is not needed. To learn more about flexible server, please visit our flexible server for MySQL page on docs.microsoft.com. Check out the flexible server intro article on techcommunity.microsoft.com. We have wonderful case studies of companies using flexible server on our customers.microsoft.com pages. We also have multiple blogs published for flexible server on azure.microsoft.com. And last but not the least, visit our free trial page linked in the description to start your free trial. Also, please reach out to us via email and follow us on our official Twitter handle for many more updates. As always, thanks for joining us and hope to see you soon.